When and where were you born?
St. Louis, Missouri, Clayton, border view city kind of thing, 1975, May 3rd. Liked television and movies and things like that, but then, like, this was this is early 80s where I'm growing up. All you had was actually going to the movie theater or stuff that would be on regular TV, like one of your, like, eight stations. And my dad was a huge movie fan. So what he would do is in the TV guide, he would see, like, oh, at 2:00 in the morning is this awesome movie I saw when I was a little kid. And for him, that meant, like, you hadn't seen it since the theater. There weren't videotapes or anything. So what he would do is he'd make a deal with us, me and my two brothers, and he'd be like, if you go to bed early, I will wake you up at 2:00 in the morning, and you can come downstairs and watch this movie with me. Like, they always seemed really important to me. So, like, and when I wasn't a huge fan of school. Movies were my thing, and I knew them. Like, it's one of those things that made me realize, like, even though that I don't like school and I don't try really hard and stuff like that, it's easy to say, but sometimes when you don't do well, it feels like, well, maybe I am not that smart or something like that. But with movies, I'm like, oh no, I get them when other people don't get them. And I know everything about them, and not everybody knows everything about them. So it became my thing, that and music. I knew what I wanted to do, and I didn't know how to do it. I wanted to do film, and I didn't know how to go about it, especially back then. It was much different. Am I gonna leave my family to go off and, like, try either California or New York? To be like, hey, trust me, I'm gonna be great at these. Like, that's a big sell. So I went to Webster, but Webster was super small at that point. That was still Webster College back then. And when you signed up for classes, they were sort of like, take what you want to take. Like, there was no real, you could just keep taking until you hit a number of hours. It didn't have to be any certain courses and stuff. And it just was not the same thing. And so I kind of bailed. And then I worked for a while, and I didn't want to go to school. I didn't know what to do, but I knew I should go to school. I didn't want to just, like, float around forever. So then I went to Merrimack. I'm glad for everybody that goes to Merrimack. I hated it. And then I transferred to SLU, and I became a theology major. Because I knew I always did well in religion. I knew it because my mom was a nun. I mean, our friends are nuns. He's a priest. Like, I know spirituality and Catholicism and world religions and stuff. It's always fascinated me. But I knew, I didn't know what that meant. Like, so I did that as my major. I took all the classes and everything, but what does that mean for, like, what I'm going to do? I want to give this film thing a try. And it was in the 90s, which was, like, the second golden era of Hollywood movies. So I went into screenwriting, knowing that, like, well, I can control the whole story from beginning to end, and then somebody else can do what they want with it. But if I can do that and then sell it, great. I transferred to Webster and did their film / screenwriting program and finished there. I was I had given myself, like, 2 years after college to write and to try to get paid. They had festivals, like they do for movies, where you can enter your parts of your screenplay and they judge it like they do a movie. I wrote one that I really liked, and I sent it out, and it even got accepted to one here. That was the first time my family got to see what I do, like, because they have this place and everybody comes and watches it and the whole deal. And then the winner gets an agent, or at least a couple agents get to read it and all this stuff. So it was kind of like a big deal. I did really well at that. That went really, really well. And my brother's a teacher at DeSmet, and he saw a posting for a job here looking for a religion teacher. Well, since I had that religion background, I was like, well, okay. And I came in, and it was when St. John's closed. So they needed somebody fast. Like, this is like 2 weeks before school started. They're like, okay, well, we'll trust you. And it was just a part-time job. It was like three religion classes. So I think it was that year. I think it was the thing that made me want to teach was that I was very strict and very kind of tough on people, especially about doing anything but outside what we were talking about or the book and that kind of stuff. And I didn't have a homeroom or anything, and I just kind of had a room where I waited. And slowly but surely, like, people I talk kind of drifted in the morning and, like, would come talk and stuff like that. So I started to get to know people, not just as students, but, like, as people. Mm-hmm. And then there was one student that came to me that year that was
having a hard time,
and she said that she was having thoughts about hurting herself.
She's coming here because she needs to talk to somebody, and I'm that person.
Oh, that's when it really clued in, like, I'm, like, in her life, and, like, she trusts me, and da-da-da. And we still talk. So that was my first class. And then kind of from there, I'm like, oh, I get it now. Like, and that was what was great about religion class, was it wasn't just about, like, here's what the Bible says, and the church says. It was, like, connecting with people and, like, talking about what you think and what you feel and your ideas and things like that. And then this job came along. UCLA. I had always pushed for having a film class, and I got that before this. But then I got this one, and this one's all about, you know, all about just the people. Once I started taking this over, then it was like, you kind of live with each other. But if I think how much my life has changed since I started here, when I started here, I was chilling and single in terms of, like, I wasn't married or anything. And I've gone from that to being engaged, to getting married, to having three kids, to being here for 10 years. Like, it's a bit, in terms of an important decade, it's probably the biggest decade of change in my life. And I hate change. But I've learned to, like, embrace it, and that's what it's all about.